Madini Mazimba, it's Proud Zimbo here. Today I greet you
with love.
So today I'll be giving you my review of the album Mutunga Dzose, which is the latest album by Leonard Kariko Gashakata, or Baba Cham, as is affectionately known by his fans. Now this album was released a couple of weeks back. I bought my copy, listened to the album, and right now I think I can give you my thoughts, my view on the album. So Baba Cham is more known, you know what, for giving us supercharged songs. His tracks are always highlighting something, they're always aimed at something, you know what. From his first album, Marowe Nyika, he tackles a lot of social and political issues. And on this track, he carried on with the same theme and format. This album is definitely supercharged. But mostly, he's talking about the issue that, you know what, a lot of Zimbos, right now things are not very good, social-wise, economic-wise, and a lot of us are suffering, you know what, we're trying to make ends meet, each and every, you know what, trying to make sure there's no balance. Most of us, you know what, when we're in my church, we're always praying day and night. Chichaga, you know, some divine intervention could have been written on. So the whole album, I think most of these tracks, maybe except one track, all of them are aimed, you know what, they're just highlighting the social unrest, the social struggles a lot of us are facing. You know what, some of those things are tension, go feel I'm cutting, which is I'm going to boy, you're just hoping with like this, I'm going to. So this album is more of addressing that issue. So in terms of production, the album is well produced. You know what, I love the instrumental arrangement on the album as a whole. He experimented with this sound a bit on tracks such as Since Weo Mambo, Madam Boss, and the last one, Mutuma. But overall, it's all well done. And you know what, generally with Zora music, it's not everyone's cup of tea, because Zora is not really that type of music. But it's more like it's made just to complement the lyrics. So it's more deep, it's more serious as compared to the other type of music. And because of that, it's not really that popular with the majority of people. But for those who love it, this is definitely an album they will enjoy a lot. So this album contains 7 tracks, and the first track is titled Pemberai Now. Now on this track, Baba Cham is just urging people, you know what, when your neighbor, when your friend succeeds or achieves something, let's learn to celebrate with them. Because success doesn't come at the same stage, Quartier, you know what, maybe for me it's today, for you it's tomorrow. But when it's your time, when it's someone's time, learn to celebrate with them. Because like he says on the album. So just learn to celebrate with those around you. Faranavo, you know what, your time will come, they will also join you and celebrate. So it's just a lovely track, it's just urging people, you know what, to go out and worry better, just better people in the community, you know what, love your neighbor, love your friend. The second track is titled Tins Weo Mambo. Now on this track, this is more of a cry to those in power, to the Lord above, but you know what, we're trying to build something, and you know what, as families, as people, we are all trying to build a lasting legacy, to build a better future for our families, for our children. But Zirukuramba, so he's just crying up to the Lord, but you know what? Tinswe yo mambo, tanswa nekutambura. We just pray for the leadership that we have, Tivene Wakuru, those who understand, those who can really relate to our sufferings, those who are willing to make life better for us. So it's a song that's reflective of how a lot of Zimbos are feeling. We just need a platform. At least we can build something for the future, or for our futures, for the futures of our families and all those around us. It's definitely a powerful, powerful track. Now the next song on the album is the title track, Mutunga Dzose. Now this track is all about declaration. You know, Zimengua, you have to stand firm, you have to be strong. This is the time that I must achieve what I wanted to achieve. And if you listen to the track, you hear him saying, you know what, so that just means that sometimes it's impossible. You just need to stand firm, you just need to stand strong. So it's quite a powerful song. It also has a lovely instrumental. I love the instrumental on this one. It's one of my favorite tracks on this album. The next track on the album is titled Shinoda Nyasha. Now on this track, Baba Cham is just saying kuti sometimes not to danyasha, because wega ungambozvikwani says no gonna kuremera ukarasika, you need grace for you to achieve what you want to achieve. It's quite a lovely track. Now on this next track, titled Vauya Nei or Painkiller. Baba Cham is just advocating for better relations between people. You know what? You and your neighbor, you and your friend. And arikutaura kuti, you know what? Ngati zivanei, tisati tatanga, so that I know how to treat you. Ngatange tazivanei, tisazonetsane. Kuti, it's always good to know your neighbor. It's always good to know that person next to you. Kuti, you now know kuti ndofa notaura na say how to address them, how can I go about my life without offending them? So it's just encouraging people to know what, let's understand each other. Kuti tikwanise kugarisana zvakanaka musociety, pasangova nebongozozo, fights and all those stuffs. Just edging us, kuti ngatingova better people. Understand your neighbor, be considerate about your neighbor. You know what, do things zvisingazokanganise umwe wako. It's quite a very, very powerful track. Now this next track is probably the most popular track from the album. Also one of my favorite tracks from the album. And it's titled Madam Boss. And it features Solomani Chimbetu and Progress Chopfumo. And it was produced by Oskid. And Opandangango, when I read all of this, you know, I was very, very anxious to listen to this track, which, how would the track come out? And then, you know what, I listened to the track, it's very, very nice, it grew on me.
What?
Is this still Zora or what? But at the end of the day, it's quite a nice track, it's a lovely track. I think it's the party track for this album. The collaboration worked very, very well. I think the elements of Sulu, the jazzy elements are of Progress Chopfumo, they all blended very well into this song. And Oski did a great job on the production. It's just solid. And the album may not get a lot of publicity or traction, but this track is definitely going to get a number of people dancing. It's just a fantastic. So the last track on the album is a track titled Mutumwa. Now this is quite different from the whole album. It's more on a jazzy, township jazzy type of vibe and arrangement. It's a lovely instrumental. I love the instrumental on this track. And also Jagata, you know what, got back to his roots. My brother Jagata, those ataiziva chikura achitonge his vibrating type of singing, the falsetto that we've come to know and love from Jagata, all of it is on this track. And it's one of those instrumentals which maybe you imagine kunzwa someone like Bob Nyabinde or Tanga Yokosando on this track. It's just fantastic. I love the instrumental. And it's the last track on the album. So in overall, this is quite a solid album. Unfortunately, it's not one of those albums which is going to be like very, very popular. A lot of people don't even know this album exists. I think it's one of those things, Yakuti, if you love Jagata, if you love Zora, you love this album. But if you're not a fan of Zora, you don't even know this album exists. Regardless of that, the production is done very well. The instrumental arrangement is definitely done quite well. You know, everything about this is very, very solid. The only downfall is that a lot of people will not be able to know about this album. Given with the other albums that are coming, like Darava Chauya Japresa, which was just released yesterday, Sulu album coming out, Winky D, this album definitely won't be getting a lot of publicity, but it's an amazing album. Buy your copy, listen to the album. Maybe you love it more than I did, maybe less, I don't know. Go in the comment section below, tell me what you think about the album, tell me what are your favorite tracks from the album. Also, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel. See you again next time.